give a fuck. I'm getting stupid loose.
I don't like your jerk off name. I don't like your jerk off face. I don't like your jerk off behavior. And I don't like you. Jerk off.
And we're back.
We're live.
How's it going?
It is going.
It is definitely going.
It's been the weirdest past couple days. So it's been like Thanksgiving. So.
And you had to work.
The kids have been out of school for like 4 days.
Yep.
But I had to work on Thanksgiving.
Yep, unfortunately.
Which, it wasn't that bad, actually.
For me, it was.
Yeah, but, like, as far as work goes, like, no administrators were there.
Yeah.
No, like, the doctors were there, but they weren't.
Slower day.
Yeah.
I got you.
So it was kind of nice. It was a little chill.
Okay.
And then we didn't have a secretary towards the end of the day. And I thought I was fine. Then we got some admissions, and I was like, I don't know what I'm doing.
I'm not fine.
But we made it work.
Yeah, no. I worked. I was off on Friday and Thanksgiving.
Yeah, what'd you do on Thanksgiving since I was working?
Well, I bright and early took our kids that are very fair skinned and very blonde.
And you are neither of those things.
Two of them in the sun. Tan really good.
Yeah.
All of them tan pretty well, but like two of them brown up.
It's the winter time, so everybody's pasty.
Yes. But
and you still have your natural tinted hue.
I do. I do have my brown. And like dark hair, hairy dude. Dark eyes. I don't look like any of the they have my cheeks and shit.
They have your cheeks.
But anyway, it looks weird. But our oldest was just like, hey, I want to cook something for Thanksgiving.
Yeah.
Because we had plans to have our coach over and the neighbors. What?
I feel like you're talking so slow right now.
So slow?
Yes.
I'm so sorry.
I'm sorry.
Is that in your mind or is it just me?
I don't know.
Could be both. High five. So anyway,
any hoodles,
we were all meeting up and she wanted to make something
with like the neighbors and our coach and
people we hang out with.
Yeah.
And she was like making an apple pie.
Yeah. She got that in her head and like,
which I don't know where she got that from, but I was like, I guess right on. Let's do it.
She likes apple pie.
And you, I think, did you suggest that we can make it from like filling?
No. Well, okay. I told her, I said, we were talking about making it, and I said, well, there are like two ways to make it. I said, you can literally just buy a pie crust and apple pie filling and make it that way, or you can actually cook it and like make it yourself.
Okay. No, that's fine. And
why?
I think she was actually even disappointed in what I said. I was down for making the filling like from scratch.
Yeah.
And she did a great job. Tasted delicious, you know. But she wanted to make the crust and everything from
scratch
flour
too?
As well, which there is a recipe there, and I was like, dude, like we could just buy pie crust.
Yeah, and like that would have taken a while.
So, and I didn't know what kind of crust we needed, so I got pie crust, and I also got the graham cracker crust, which we didn't use.
I'm sure we can find something to use it with.
I'm sure. But no, her apple pie for her first try was pretty good. Tasted really good. It just, it may have been a little more my oversight. It baked a little long, I think.
That's all right.
Right?
Then I got home at like 9 o'clock and was able to inhale food at the neighbor's house for like what felt like 30 minutes. And then I was like, I'm tired.
I mean, it was a long day.
Yeah.
We got out to like, so they can all play.
It was like 3 o'clock.
No, it was before that. As soon as our youngest woke up from his nap, I took him out. It was like 1:30 or 2.
So they were hanging out literally all day.
Yeah.
We're going to see y'all, not just they.
Right. So then eventually I just brought all the food over. We just hung out and ate. And hung out and then ate again. But it was a good day.
It was. And then we put up Christmas decorations.
Yeah.
When I was putting them up outside, you had, it's really bubbly.
Yeah.
Is that what you're looking at?
It's my seltzer because now I'm caring about my girlish figure. It's definitely that.
That was a weird laugh. I'm sorry. Anyways, I was putting up Christmas decorations, and one of our neighbors kept like coming over and like watching, and like I don't know. It was weird.
I spilled all over myself.
It's okay.
I think we talked about that last time.
Did we?
Yeah.
Well, fine.
How he was odd. The day after that, we hung out some curtains.
Yeah, we got some light curtains that are really cool.
And I'm counting down the days until there are light
some
curtains.
Some random obscure holiday? Oh.
No, until
the neighbor has them.
But, I'm sure in a few weeks.
Oh, yeah.
Be like, hey, man, did you get those from Amazon?
Yeah, for sure.
Got them from your mom.
And they're
mom.
Cool because on the app you can put like any picture.
They're awesome. They're we're not obviously not sponsored or anything, but Govee light curtains. They're
I mean, if you
awesome.
If you want to sponsor us, that's cool too. But
that'd be great. It's a great fucking product.
No, but they were so cool. Our oldest was playing with the things on your phone, and she was so excited to show me that you could put a cheeseburger on there.
Not
which
only
is
that,
so cool to me because like why? But why not?
So apparently, you can actually even like design stuff.
So could you seriously write F the HOA?
Oh, I could. I could write like scrolling messages and stuff. And we have multiple. We can put it across both of them.
Yeah. Could we do that on like a kid's birthday?
Yeah.
That'd be so cool.
We could.
Aw.
Yeah.
That'd be so cute.
I got to figure out how to do it, but yeah.
Well, yeah, and I'm sure they have a cake option or something if they have a cheeseburger.
A cheeseburger?
Sorry, I'm putting my Capri Sun.
Ooh, you're so grown up.
Speaking of lights, you said something about a music festival light show was causing blindness.
Oh, shit. I gotta Google that. But yeah, I hold on.
Yeah, you briefly mentioned it and I had no idea what you were talking about. But while you're looking that up, we went to a light show.
We did.
Last night. Where we drove through the speedway,
yeah,
the racetrack, and they had a bunch of different Christmas lights out, which was really cool. And then on one side, they had the music lights, the lights like synced up with the music.
Yeah.
That was pretty cool. Except for sometimes when there was like a, like it.
It's seizure inducing.
Very much so. I mean, not that I have seizures, thankfully, but.
Attendees report severe eye and vision problems after Bored Ape NFT festival.
What?
Yeah. So let's see what the vibe. Oh, geez. So that doesn't look crazy. Like from
regular,
a video, it looks like just a fucking club party. But I guess. Like, when all those lights are, like, just glowing in your face. The fuck?
I guess.
So, all right. This, from this post, it just looks like a bunch of NFT bros.
And, like, regular flashing club lights.
Yeah. Having a blast in a club.
Yeah, they're having a good old time. 30 hours since woken up with severe eye burn and visited the emergency hospital and spent there 6 hours.
Wow.
Photokeratitis over both eyes, accident related.
That sucks. No serious cornea damage, thankfully. Scroll.
That's crazy.
Right? That, yeah. Total of 6 hours in the emergency hospital or eye clinic. Got diagnosed with blah, 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 blah.
Jeez.
Snow blindness. That's what I thought when you were too high on cocaine.
Maybe.
But it's a form. But no, this is on the post. It says, snow blindness is a form of photo whatever that is caused by UV rays reflected off ice and snow.
That's why you have to wear like sunglass goggles.
That's why I'm so glad I got these transforming or whatever they're called.
Transformers glasses.
So, yeah, my lenses are pretty cool.
They are.
Although, like, and I haven't worn them to an office situation where I'm wondering if the office lights are giving off UV that they'll just turn.
Take both pair, just in case.
That is fair. Or contacts. And just freak everyone out. Be like, don't worry, I can see. And just like run into a wall.
You goober. That's silly.
Oh, wow. We are aware of the eye-related issues that affected some of the attendees. Have been proactively reaching out to individuals yesterday. Much less of 1% of those. I guess 1% of those attendees. Aw. 1% of those attending and working the event had these symptoms. Well, nearly everyone in this has indicated their symptoms have improved. We encourage anyone that feels them. Okay.
So seek medical attention.
But can you imagine you're attending, like, I'm guessing it was a party?
Yeah, that's what it sounds like.
That's what it looked like, so.
Like, you do look creepy in this picture.
I'm all bottom teeth on that one for some reason.
Because you were making a funny face? No, because look at her. Look at her smile. Oh, it's top teeth. Never mind.
No, we both can't smile for different reasons.
And then the baby. Oh my gosh. So we were in line to see Santa.
They were fine.
And all the kids were fine.
Yeah.
The baby was fine. The oldest kid was fine. The middle one, like every time we took a step closer, she was like a little more iffy. So I bribed her with hot chocolate.
That's why she was so adamant on hot chocolate.
Yeah, because okay. I told her if she smiled with Santa, we would go get hot chocolate. She's like,
fuck you, dude. I did it. We're getting some hot chocolate. I didn't know these deals were made. Okay. So then we got up. All at this light show that we went to. No one was blind.
No, you didn't get blinded. No, but we got there, and I was like keeping my eyes on her. So I was like, okay, cool. She's sitting up. She's smiling. And I look up, and our baby is just wailing.
Dude, and he was sitting with his oldest sister.
Yeah, and nobody loves staying with her, but he was so mad.
In the history of our kids and Santa, you know what I mean? Like, it hasn't.
Yeah, none of them liked him, especially the first time.
Yeah, no, dude. Do you remember the oldest one?
Yeah, remember we had to get at that same place. We had to get an Elsa person to like stand behind us and smile, make her smile.
Yeah,
because remember,
her
like
sister. It was either the year before. Her sister, or the year her sister was a baby, that we had to do that.
Yeah.
So that's not too long ago. She was about the middle one's age.
That year it was just the oldest that we had to get Elsa.
She was about the middle one's age.
Yeah.
So that makes sense. The middle one was iffy about the whole thing. She was like, I don't know this dude. And I was like, I'm proud of you. But everyone wants to see this goddamn picture. Go
she was dead set on some freaking hot chocolate, which was hilarious.
Dude.
Wasn't even good. And I don't like chocolate.
It wasn't the best. I do like chocolate, and I tried a sip of it, and I was just like, eh.
I like real, I guess, rich hot chocolate I can do.
That's fair.
No, but we were in
line.
Depends
on the setting, too. Like, if we go snowboarding.
Yeah, like a good right hot after, chocolate. Yeah.
Right?
Yeah. So, I was in a rush leaving, and I forgot to grab my jacket.
Yeah.
So, I was cold, and all these lines were ridiculously long. And so I kept trying to get the middle one to be like, dude, hey, we'll make hot chocolate at home. And she was not accepting that.
I mean.
Which we did make a deal, so props, fine.
Right?
That's why I stood in line.
The little one was on me outside and at this point, falling asleep.
Yep, he fell asleep. And you went to go sit on a bench with him. And there's like one person or one group in front of us.
Yeah.
And the woman that's ordering. Oh, is
I
literally
all this.
Yeah, you did because you're sitting with the baby.
Yeah.
Is literally wanting to read the ingredient list for everything she's ordering. So she's ordering hot chocolate, and I see the woman behind the counter grabbing a big tub of Swiss Miss and flipping it over and like going through the ingredients with her.
But she's scanning it and on then, her map because I understand that struggle.
No.
I'm on the scanning struggle right now for my macros.
No, they were like going through the ingredients. And then she did that with the funnel cake dough too. She like wanted to see the ingredient list on that too.
Did they also forever. Give her the protein content of on the boogers and cum that she probably ate as well?
Right.
Fucking crazy kook.
Yeah, I don't know. I don't know what she was looking for. Like, if your allergies are that bad, like, maybe bring your own snacks or, like.
Don't eat.
Right. Like, you wait in this long line. Like, what if whatever they're giving you is not appropriate for your dietary restrictions.
Like, to an extent, I feel bad because like you know what you need to have where or when, and if that could be an issue.
Right, especially when you're in the line that only has like drinks, hot chocolate, and funnel cakes.
Yeah, I mean the sign was pretty clear, right?
So like, what if you get to the front and none of that like flows with your dietary restrictions? Then you're just waiting that long line for nothing.
Oh, I'm sure she would say something before she left.
I don't know. It annoyed me a little bit.
You guys don't have soy, whatever, blah, 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 non-cookies? It's like, no, yeah, we don't.
It annoyed me a little bit. Like,
I don't know what to tell you. I've been with, like, in public to dinner through, like, projects that I had to work and stuff with people with dietary restrictions, if you will. Some of them are cool. And they will just low-key find something that they can eat.
Yeah.
Some of them are real cunts about it.
Right. Like, hey, I want
you never want to go to dinner with that person ever again.
I want the spaghetti and meatballs, but I need you to make it low-carb and vegan and gluten-free. And
when I was working on that project with the lady that was Ms.
Yeah.
She had all sorts of restrictions because of her side gig, if you will, being in a Miss America pageant and all that. But even her, like, she would just pick something that she could do. She was like, hey, can I not have the sauce? And that was the extent of it.
Right. And that's fine.
And like, I'm cool with that.
Yeah.
But like, some vegans that we've gone out with that is just like, let's never get sushi with them again, because I don't understand what you're getting into.
Well, going and it's into different a sushi too, restaurant. Because also just like find something that you can do.
Yeah.
And order it.
Oh, I'm with you.
Like, don't make that person go with you, read the entire menu to you, so you know that the salmon roll has salmon in it.
Exactly. Be like, hey, does your stuff have X or peanuts?
Right. Like, can you recommend something
gluten, whatever. Oh, it does have gluten. Do you have anything without gluten, peanuts, whatever? No, thank you. That should be the extent of that interaction, no? Yeah, that's annoying.
Shoot, look up the recipe before the restaurant's menu, like on the way there.
Dude, it's horrible, but it's like, isn't food allergies like the old joke that I say, like just Mother Nature's way of saying you're not its favorite kid?
No.
It kind of is. It's like, it's the lamest, one of the lamest ways to go.
It's probably one of the shittiest, though.
Oh, yeah. Like, your asphyxiation and shit. No, thanks. Yeah. No, I'm not claiming it's not a horrific way to go. But it's like, in the grand scheme of luck, you can be taken out by something you can eat. That's kind of horrible and weak.
Or by like a bee. You can't control that.
That's another horrible one too, because bees sometimes are cunts.
For no reason sometimes, yeah.
Dude, I used, when one of my first jobs, when we moved to America, one of my first jobs, I tried to work on a shitty Brazilian accent again and I can't.
Yeah, that wasn't a good one. That sounded like half Asian.
Yeah, dude, I can't do it. I get made fun of. Like Matt makes fun of me all the time.
Because you sound like you're a white guy trying to impersonate a random ass foreign accent. Yeah,
I know, dude. And I'm like, no, man. Like, hang out with my mom. Like, she sounds like Vanderlei Silva.
I'm telling you, for the first,
and I
like,
wish I had that.
For the first,
I wish I had the ability to tap into that.
For a while, when we first got together, I was scared to go anywhere with her alone because I was so worried that I wouldn't be able to understand her and that, like, it wasn't going to be good.
And she also has her own, like, little idioms, if you will.
You forbed.
Forb instead of far and like things like that, but
she's
like
make shit up. It's like, is that Portuguese, babe? Nope.
It's like, no, that's something else. That's her. That's all. That's an original.
it's an original.
But yeah, no, like I don't know where I was going with the accent thing.
When you first moved to America,
my first job.
Wow, that accent wasn't good either.
That was rough. That wasn't Brazilian.
No,
Brazilian accent is really rough. I need to watch more UFC like interviews. When they get in,
I can't even like think in my head of what your mom sounds like now.
If I speak in Portuguese, I can do my mom to like my brother. That sounded very inappropriate.
Wow. What?
Wow. Okay.
You want to say that again?
No. If I speak in Portuguese, I can imitate my mom's voice when I'm like talking shit to my brother.
That sounded much better.
Yeah.
Yes.
Wow. The first one. Oh, louco, Gabriel. Oh, louco. Vocês estão doido. Vocês estão doido.
What does that mean?
You're all crazy. No. Você bebeu? Você bebeu? Are you drunk? That's another one. But anyway, the first job I had, I obviously was like a fucking dishwasher slash busboy slash anything that needed done. I literally shoveled a parking lot for like most of the day, to the point that my mom saw it happening when she came back, and she came with a shovel to like help me out. And then she was pissed afterwards. She's like, you can't just stay outside, like fuck these people. And I was just like, well, you know,
you can't just outside.
You can't just shovel their fucking drill. Like, I was like, mom, like, it's what this motherfucker was paying us for, and you know what I mean? As a fucking immigrant and shit, you don't necessarily complain about shit.
Yeah.
But we would throw away garbage in this little closed-in, like, fenced-in dumpster area. And sometimes, of course, fucking bees.
Mm-hmm.
You start a nest there, you wouldn't know. You opened it up just to throw the garbage, or sometimes even throwing it over.
Yeah.
They would fucking, they knew. They were waiting. Like, they would just send one of them kamikaze just to, like, fucking sting you and die.
Mm.
And that shit, yeah. If we were allergic then, dude, I'd have been fucked.
Yeah. I've only been stung one time, and I was, like, walking in my grass in my front yard as a kid, and I stepped on one.
Yeah.
And that was it. And that was the only time I've ever been stung.
Did I tell you about my mom getting stung all over her head and shit?
You told me that, like, recently she got stung and realized that she's allergic.
Oh, dude. And if she wasn't, she became allergic. That's how many times she apparently was stung.
Poor thing.
And so...
Didn't she, like,
she was mowing.
Yeah.
All right. And it just, like, one of those, like, she went under a tree, thought it was fine, and then just brushed against the wrong fucking branch.
Mm.
And her head just... I laugh now because, like, I just remember she didn't talk to me for like 3 or 4 days. Disappeared, yeah. Which is very unlike her.
Yeah.
And when she finally surfaced, she's like, "No, I ended up in a fucking ER, and I got stung like 20 some odd times in the head."
Jeez.
And the lady was just like, "Yeah, you could have fucking died." Like, I was like, "Yeah, that's a lot." Like, I'm assuming each one has a little bit of venom, but that's a lot of it, and right in your fucking
your head. Yeah.
So now, you know, she was swollen up and shit, and they took out, I guess, apparently not all of the fucking
stingers.
Because, like, weeks later, she was having, like, still some of the symptoms and went back, and I think they found, like, a few more.
Jeez.
But she's carrying an EpiPen and all that shit now.
Oh, that's crazy.
Oh, look.
Oh, my gosh.
But she was fine.
Well, I'm glad she was okay.
Yeah.
Yesterday I was taking a shower and the kids are supposed to be playing in their rooms. And as I'm like taking my clothes off and finding clothes to put on afterwards and all that stuff,
yeah,
they slowly start surfacing like one by one.
Oh, wonderful.
So the oldest and the youngest were in there, and they had a bouncy ball. And I was like, okay, well, y'all just play with that on the floor then.
Yeah.
I'm going to take a shower. Next thing I know, the baby climbed into the bathtub. I was like, okay, he's contained.
He knows how to turn
fine.
That water on.
So it ended up.
Yeah.
This is what it ended up being. All three kids, fully clothed, in our bathtub.
I don't give a fuck.
That's pretty nice.
They didn't. He would turn the water on every once in a while, but the oldest kid had piled up a towel right underneath the
That's why those the thing. Were there.
So if he turned it on for like a second before she caught it, it would dry it up. And then they were throwing this ball over the shower and into the shower. And they were all just cackling. It was cracking me up.
They're fucking crazy.
Um, And one more thing, sir.
Yeah.
Sir.
What?
So, you know how I told you the day that I found like a 47 second long video.
Yeah.
At like 10 o'clock while we were sleeping.
Yeah.
And I figured I just fell asleep. So I remembered what happened.
We'll do it live. Fuck it.
Yeah. I woke up to you snoring.
Okay.
And I started taking a video of you snoring, and then I fell asleep taking the video.
Did you catch me snoring? Hold on. Stop. We can get connected to the Bluetooth.
Okay.
No, don't fuck with me, bitch. That's hilarious. Let me know when you're connected.
Hang on.
It's these spinning. Nuts.
It's connected.
You're good. Whenever you want. So you fell asleep filming me snore. This is not bad.
It's not bad.
I'm breathing. What are you filming? Like, what exactly?
This is your face. Or it was. See?
I see now.
That's your face. That's my hand.
I don't hear anything. I stop for a few seconds.
You were snoring.
Dude, I have this cranked up as hot as the mics. Do you have that turned up all the way? Yeah, you do.
Okay, at the time it seemed way louder.
I cranked it all the way up. That's not bad, you pussy.
It's not. At the time it seemed way louder though.
You fucking... Oh, I'm so sorry. I was breathing, honey.
The point is that I realized what I took, why I took the video.
This thing sucks.
I'm actually fine.
What's up? Yeah, no, it was a random fucking video. And I was like, why did we even find that? I mean, that's not wrong. That's not wrong.
Fruits and vegetables. Oh, these kiddos. I've been determined to try to get a video of our baby walking.
He is not very...
And I swear, every time I pull the phone out, he just flops down.
He knows.
I guess. Chug, 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 chug. Dude, the noises that our kid makes is cracking me up. Like, he won't talk.
Dude,
he'll say, like, dog, and mama, and dada, and ball.
Up, sometimes.
Sometimes he'll say up, and sometimes he'll say this when he's pointing at stuff.
This?
So he does say some things.
This?
But, like, today he crawled into the middle kid's room and found a pink, like, baby doll hairbrush.
Oh, dude.
And he started brushing his hair with it. That was so cute. And then he came and started brushing yours.
Yeah, he would come over and, like, climb up on my knee, and, like, I would bend over so he can actually reach my head. And he's, like, brushing it, and then... Thanks, man.
And then Appreciate he found it. A spoon and he like shoved it in your face and you said no and he went.
Yep. He's very observant. And I think also like the fact that like all of us talk around him.
Yeah.
It's probably a little intimidating.
Well, he also knows that he doesn't have to talk to get his way.
Yeah, that's a little scary.
Is it?
Yeah, I don't want this dummy fucking grunting through his fucking 12th birthday.
No, he won't.
You know? But...
That's why he's just now walking at almost 18 months.
Yeah, because everything's just kind of...
Because the oldest especially like, will carry him everywhere.
Yeah. He knows. He goes to her quite a bit. And it's...
Excuse me.
And initially kind of scary. Like when she started like mm-hmm. carrying him.
Well, then, like, as she gets stronger and gets better, then he gets bigger.
Yeah, but he's getting exponentially bigger. That's the issue. He's big.
A chunky boy.
But, like, no, he gets about, like, 5-6 steps
mm-hmm.
at a time. And then he realizes he wants to go quicker, so he plops down and starts crawling. Remember when he started crawling, he would, like, kind of, like, do a worm. On his belly.
Yep. It took him the longest time to get from the worm to the actual crawl.
Yeah. My mom said my brother used to do the same shit.
That's funny.
Just like go like splatting his fucking belly on the floor. And in Brazil, like there's not a lot of carpeted
Yeah.
At least there wasn't when I was there. Not a lot of carpeted houses. So it's all like either hardwood or like tile.
Mm-hmm.
So you're just here, smack, smack, smack. And you just have that fucking red belly.
That's so funny.
And it's, fucking nuts.
Snucking futs, man.
What else you got, bitch?
I don't know. I was about to say something else and then I lost it.
You didn't do any, what was I going to say? You didn't do any Black Friday shopping?
No, I've been really good and I got on my Christmas. You
did a return and you were like, what? No.
I did a return later in the afternoon and I forgot that it was Black Friday.
Yeah.
And the lines were crazy, but I ended up standing in line to get like a hoodie, but I gave it to the kids.
Yeah.
Right away.
You ready?
Mm-hmm.
I got some videos.
There's Wu-Tang Clan and somebody smoking a joint, it looks like. Ugh. Oh my gosh, this person just inhaled that into their lungs. Blunt. Oh my gosh, that makes me hurt. It makes me want to vomit. I want to vomit. And did he go to the hospital after that? Like, what do you do?
I don't know. I hope he turned off the video.
He's still breathing probably. He's just like...
But like, that's probably burning the inside of your fucking mouth.
Yeah, it's burning his throat and it's getting him exponentially blazed at the same time.
At a rate that like, I'm assuming even if he had saliva,
no,
it would not put it out, right?
No. Because it wouldn't be enough.
Mm-hmm.
Oh. What are all those noises coming out of you?
I don't know, man. It's a lot going on.
What are you doing?
This isn't working.
The funniest doorbell camera.
Drop by to hang out with a friend.
Yeah.
But ended up at the wrong house.
So, it's a suspicious looking fella. Like, if I came to someone's doorknob.
Yeah.
They'd be like, who the fuck is this dude?
And what happened next nearly got him arrested.
He's just being all goofy. Dave opened the door.
Habibi, Habibi.
Can I help you?
Delivery.
You can leave it on the floor.
With the door locked, the man decided to act silly and play around. But the homeowner was not playing around at all.
Who are you? I don't know who you are. All right, I'm going to call the police.
Oh my God.
Oh my gosh.
A police officer arrived to find out what's going on. Man apologized for an honest mistake.
It's hilarious.
Poor guy.
In his mind, like, I could have been this dude. In his mind, he's just like trying to like hang out with his bud.
And he's being so silly. Like, I'd be totally goofy. Yeah,
there's a fucking terrorist out here. What's up, Habibi? Habibi? Like, fucking just being a dude.
Oh my gosh, poor guy.
Fucking Dave is going to laugh at this shit. Dave's going to love this. Come on, Dave. Stop fucking around, dude. Open the door. He's like, I'm going to call the cops. He's like, oh, shit. Oh, is this...
Oh.
Is this 11? I meant 13. I'm sorry, pal.
I don't know who you are.
I don't know who you are. Delivery. Leave it at the door, please.
And that poor guy probably thinks that his friend is like just fucking with him too. And he's like, I'm going to call the cops. I don't know who you are.
Oh, I don't know. When he said like, I'm going to call the cops. He kind of was like,
I don't know you.
No, that's not Dave. Dave. What's up, Dave? All right. Says when this little
was climbing on something in the house, she
girl
accidentally fell over. And her brother's reaction to it is hilarious.
I'm okay. Precious.
When this little girl...
She said that my mom reflexes. Like, mom reflexes didn't work that time.
Nope.
Yeah, she just went, like, fucking face first. But she not bad. Like, the bench broke her fall. She was safe. The little he made the right call. She's okay, Derek Lewis would say.
As he would say, she is okay.
Yeah, no, he waved it. Pretty safe. Has any of them taken a spill? We have very clumsy kids.
Yeah.
Have any of them?
But
one of them has a mark on her forehead, and she doesn't know what from.
Yes, she does.
She does? What is it from?
I figured it out.
Tell me.
So, you know those little, like, fidget toys that she has? There's one that's like a tube, and you can, like, extend it or put it back together.
I don't know that one, but
it's
sure.
It's a clear plastic tube, okay. And you can bend it like a straw, like the bendy part of a straw, but big.
Okay.
So she had one end in her mouth and one end on her forehead.
Why the fuck would she do that?
Oh no. She didn't know it was gonna leave Mark. But let me tell you, I had to pull this out of her because she kept saying, I don't know, I think I hit myself in the head with this tube. And I'm like, kiddo, like there's no way that tiny, that thin, like that thin straw like tube hitting in the forehead made a bruise. Like, what are you talking about? She's like, I don't know. I just kept touching it to my head.
Oh,
and I was like, okay. And I thought about it and I thought about
okay.
it.
Now let's try to get an answer from someone who's not a complete retard.
I thought about it and I was like, were you like sucking on the other end while you had it on your forehead? And she was like, yeah. Like, that's where.
I'm actually fine.
She gave herself a fucking icky on her forehead.
Fucking idiot. Oh, dude. My cousin used to. She used to do that to, like, her arm and shit.
I did, too.
And she's like, why the fuck? Why do you want to do that? It's so stupid.
I did it, too. We all did.
Oh, that doesn't so make sorry. It any less retarded.
I know. You're right. It doesn't. It surely doesn't.
Oh, dude, I was wondering. I was like, could she have done anything in class that, like,
well, I'm sitting here freaking out. I'm like, because she didn't want to tell us. I'm like, oh, my God, some kid's, like, bullying her in school. Like, that's where my mind went. And I was like, she's scared to tell us.
We'll fix that problem real quick.
Because I noticed it on Thanksgiving when we were video chatting. And I was like, hey, what's on your forehead?
Yeah.
So I'm like, did she get hit, like, 2 days ago and it's just now showing up? And then finally, I think I scared her, too, because I was like, I need to know, because if you're just randomly getting bruises with nothing happening, like, that could be an issue.
Yeah, that's like, true.
Tell me.
Oh, my God.
Oh, my gosh.
All right, this one's called Confident Black Belt. Or at least this is what I called it. Oh, Jesus, fuck.
Okay. I love my safe defense classes.
Yeah, they're called Safe Defensive Class. And and I guess both kids are wearing black belts. Would you concur?
That's what it looks like from here.
All right. Let's roll.
So I want to see what they've been practicing on and being safe with your sister.
There's no being safe in a fight, first of all. Like, his sister needs to be defensive.
Is Ludacris talking?
I don't know. All right, that's fair. Don't try to knock your sister out. Those are horrible jabs. How is she a black belt? Okay.
They haven't done anything but walk in circles.
Right. You see those black belts, right?
Did they start at a black belt?
I don't know, because that stance is horrible. Smack those fucking four eyes right off her face, dude. She's probably tough. I don't know, man.
That's weird.
The sister's not very tough. He, like, could have... Does that look like a fucking black belt in anything?
No.
Except getting your fucking ass
They're
kicked.
Just walking around in circles.
He's trying. Like, he's not, like, black belt level. Like, no one blocks like this. But his hands are up. Is this like a trial class where they wear a black belt for the trial to build the confidence? It's like, you could be a black belt one day.
I hope so.
No, you sit there and let her hit you. A black belt who doesn't know a fucking jab. Where do you get this, man? Like, I get it. Build your confidence. But, like, he's like, hey, man, like, I don't want to be part of your fucking video. Can we just box? It's a nice mat room that they have there.
Yeah, I like the blue and black.
Yeah. Puzzle mats are rough, though. What, she headbutted your camera? Oh, nice block. Nice. Right in the fucking buzzer. What? That was nothing.
Oh my god!
I didn't watch the whole video earlier. I thought like he would just like smack the nerd right out of her.
Nope, definitely but, not.
I did send this to.
This link is okay. Never mind.
What's up?
You're right.
What?
I was making sure you were gonna go back and get the critic link.
I got it. I got it.
Sorry.
Plus, I have it over here. It's a confident black belt. She is very confident.
Mm-hmm.
So confident, she doesn't know what a fucking jab is. Anything else? Any video that piques your fancy?
I can't read that for me. I don't have my glasses on. Oh, dumb dear. Survival brood.
They're dumb survival broad. What do you think this is about?
Somebody that wants to be on Naked and Afraid, thinking that they can do it.
Oh, you so know it. What can you describe the picture here as?
Two naked people in the woods.
Okay. Anything more?
No.
The fish are making me fart.
She's farting a lot.
I have a problem.
What?
I just sharted.
She just sharted. Dude.
Luckily, I wasn't sitting on my bag. Look away.
He's like, I don't want to be here with you, shardy pants.
Hey, don't know. Hell no. Don't wash it out in the water hole.
So she just climbs in.
Oh, no.
Like a teeny bit. No.
It's fine. These things poop
disgusting.
In the
water. Disgusting.
Where else would you like me to clean my bum?
Anywhere else.
Okay, let me go find another watering hole for you.
Have you been doing this whole time?
This is my first time. I haven't sharded yet.
That is the worst thing you could do.
Oh,
contaminate the water supply. Yeah,
yeah.
I'd say that's a pretty bad one. Would you like some tea?
Beyond my control. I don't want to be medically tapped because somebody else's poor decisions. You do understand that's toxic.
That water is toxic. We boil it. Everything you drink had poop in it at one point.
I mean, why show his nipples and not hers? You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I don't know.
I get that. It's been purified to a sense. This is going to have floaters in there.
Floaters.
Ew.
Literally, water. It didn't even have a smell. You could smell my fingers if you want.
No.
What?
Nice.
You could smell my fingers if you want.
I am really glad you're finding some humor in this because I am not at all.
He's like, no, we can actually die.
He's so pissed.
I'm gonna skip around.
How does he know that?
But that affects my challenge.
Well, it's done and I'm moving on and I won't do it again. So you could keep being mad about it.
I am going to take a day to get over this. That is disgusting.
Time to get over it. Convenient. Time to move on.
Hey, do you have to like keep your partner alive?
Right.
Kill her.
I was embarrassed, so I'm just gonna give him his time and
not work.
You're embarrassed? Like, you're the one that wiped out your poopy butt in the water that you guys drink and eat from.
There's a portion of this. It's a 9-10 minute video. I'm trying to go to the most replayed areas.
I just want to lay down and not move. My body is trying to push me to go get food. What? Dead fish.
Jeez, I wonder why.
I've done that. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
What could have done that?
I'm super nervous about Matt saying it was my poop.
Oh no, probably was.
I have to go sit down because I'm gonna pass out. Don't have any energy.
Dude, I hope he like just left her there. And
oh
just...
man.
I didn't watch it this far. No, tomorrow.
I had diarrhea twice yesterday.
So all our fish down here are dead?
I've seen 5.
She had diarrhea twice yesterday. Where?
Right.
Well,
Why are you bringing that up if it's not relevant?
I'm telling you, the amount of poop I had on my butt was like that much. So that could have caused it. Or.
Yeah,
you
or.
Had stagnant water and it smelled like dead animal.
Yeah, some good looking fish.
Your shit killed them. Good job, Emily.
All right, you can still eat them. Water that's been sitting in fish.
A bunch of dead stuff floating in it.
I'd be so mad.
Keyword floating.
A bunch of dead stuff floating in it. I'd be so mad if I were him.
See your turds over there, Amber? Yeah, that's insane. Like, how is that lady in a Survivor show?
How is he not killing her?
They would have to like pay off a lot of cameramen.
Yeah.
He's like, hey, like, can we like prop up like a scene where she's like, oh no, she fell off a hill, and we'll just throw her body over. And that's what we captured the fall.
Like, oh, she tripped.
Like, oh no. Sorry, Amber, no.
Oopsies, no.
But yeah, I don't know. It would be worth it. Like, what are the winnings that you get? Do you win money?
Yeah.
Like a lot of money?
I don't remember how, like $250,000 maybe? $100,000?
Okay, so like how many cameramen you probably have on you? Like, let's assume you have two.
How much do you win on Naked and Afraid?
You win recognition.
Man. No way.
What?
The winner on Naked and Afraid takes home a lump sum of $5,000?
$5,000?
No way.
Fuck you. That's not enough to pay cameramen to murder this bitch.
No, that's not enough to do that at all.
Hey, man, I'll give you $1,000 and you can have a home cooked meal any Wednesday you want to come over.
Any Wednesday.
Like, what the fuck?
A few $1,000. It's more about the experience than the money.
Okay. I would like to experience fucking murder after this bitch. Like,
wow.
That sucks. $5,000. So they get people to pretty much embarrass themselves and show their titties to another dude. Which
right.
For us, it's all blurry. We just get blurry bits. But,
but like, it means you're sitting in sand and getting sand in your crotch and all your crevices.
Oh, I'm aware.
And getting sunburned on your crotch and your butt cheeks.
You could be asleep and an ant could literally just bite your fucking taint.
Yeah, a fire ant. Could you imagine?
Could happen.
A scorpion could just sneak up and just
right
in your ball
right
sack.
In the gooch. Yeah, could happen. That sucks, but $5,000.
Not worth it.
If I make this, $5,000.
Not worth it.
That's crazy.
I will sleep in a sleeping bag in my backyard for $5,000.
I'm willing to do that.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's Although naked in my back, well, fuck
no,
him.
I didn't agree to being naked.
Naked and afraid in our backyard.
But not naked.
The fear would be, is our creepy neighbor outside? I guess if we're outside naked, I guess we're the creepy ones.
We have a fence.
But, yeah, but still, right?
It'd be creepier if I was clothed and you were naked and he was still watching.
I don't know. I don't want to find out what he's into. Let's put it that way.
It still weirds me out the one time that y'all were fixing the deck and y'all had gone to Lowe's to get more stuff, you and the good neighbor. I was in the hammock. I was in the hammock with like my shorts rolled up and my shirt pulled up and my headphones in, and I was like singing. And then next thing I know, I open my eyes and he's walking right up. And I was like, what the? Okay, hi.
Yeah.
Like, why are you walking into my backyard when you clearly just saw them leave?
It's also hilarious how like, he'll tell us, he was like, oh no, I'm on like medical disability from this and this and that.
Right.
But then had no problem unloading whatever planks we had for that deck just because he wanted to like talk and be heard.
Right. And try to impress you.
And it's, I don't know, man. People are weird.
People are weird.
I don't.
That's a fact, Jack.
I don't get along with too many of them for
obvious reasons.
I also attract, I think, crazy motherfuckers.
Yeah.
Like, generally, I don't try to. I think I'm just like a fucking light beacon to all these crazy
moths.
Like
a moth to a flame.
Yeah, yeah. And eventually I fucking explode. That's the issue.
Because they get close and think you're best.
And then I'm the asshole.
And then.
Oh, Lord. I remember when that movie came out.
I love that movie.
I know you do.
Christy Boner.
What'd you think of...
We watched Groundhog Day today.
Groundhog Day. I almost said Good Will Hunting.
No, it was cute. It was a cute movie.
Yeah.
We'll talk about it more later, but... No, it was a good movie. It was a good movie, and the kids got into it, too. The girls really got into it.
Yeah, yeah, they were... Even the middle one was kind of into it. All right, we'll wrap this one up.
I thought I had to, like, burp, and then I gagged, and then I...
Ooh.
It was a weird combination of things.
No, we're good. I have no plans for the rest of the weekend. I just want to relax.
I'm going to hang out with Mom at some point tomorrow. I'm not sure what we're doing, but...
That sounds exhausting. But anyway, I love you.
I love you.
And we'll see you cunts next Tuesday.
See you next Tuesday.
I don't give a fuck. I'm getting stupid loose.
I don't like your jerk off name. I don't like your jerk off face. I don't like your jerk off behavior. And I don't like you. Jerk off.